Love your shoes, though.
You can't enter without being searched. It's standard procedure.
This is ridiculous.
Well, that's how it is. Think about it, and come back if you want. I'll be waiting upstairs in the reception. Understood?
Kristen.
My body.
It's a smoking area. If you don't like it, piss off.
Jesus, I'm just asking nicely.
No, you were being a bitch. Now go away and bitch.
Not bad, other than the face.
Like, or do something worse than blowing cancer in your face.
Oh my God, what is your problem? You are sick.
You have no idea.
Oh. Hey, how are you?
You are trespassing. Please turn around. Yeah, and stay out.
Okay, look, if you can still hear me, I am going to get out. Help! Somebody, help!
Okay. Hello, sir.
Upstairs, that is the Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali's private penthouse, correct? I heard rumors he has some guests of some significance. Now, I understand you probably signed an NDA.
Hey there, big guy. Excuse me, if you're coming through, I have to frisk you. Only take a minute, okay? Just a quick pat down, sir. Nothing to worry about. Thank you. Please proceed.
Oh, Mr. Kazim, I'm glad you changed your mind.
Arrogance can be a dangerous trait.
Yes, indeed, it can. Mr. Ingram has been expecting you. We have a conference room set up for you.
Greetings, sir.
Please, go in and make yourself comfortable. Mr. Ingram will be with you shortly.
Thank you.
Hey, bud.
Mr. Kazim, a pleasure to meet you. Omar tells me great things about you. I'll get straight to the point. I have a, well, let's call it a dispute, which the Royal Highness tells me you're very capable of taking care of. Now, I've worked with your organization before, in Morocco, I believe, so I'm a little hesitant.
Don't be. We do what's needed.
Well, only time will tell. I have two assignments for you. Take care of the first one, and then we can discuss the bigger fish. Now, on to the first. An acute problem has been brought to my attention.
Keep talking.
I'll be candid with you. No one is supposed to know that I'm here. However, there's a journalist down at the inauguration, and he's asking rather intrusive questions about who's staying up here, and that is a very dangerous problem for me. Now, I want you to silence this little pain. You think you can do that?
It's what I do best.
I like your bluntness. This is his file. Hans looked. Pulitzer-winning freelance journalist. He's good. And won't give up until he gets the answers he needs. And that can't happen.
Consider it done.
Good man. And remember, I want a picture. I want proof so I can sleep tonight.
Of course.
Once this little assignment is completed, come back and talk to Miss Toe. Then we can discuss the real cancer that needs to be removed. I'm sure you can see yourself out.
That's Carl Ingram, Provident's partner and brass-balled billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
the elevator now.
Yes. Hello, sir.
Heightened security measures means I can't let you through here, mate.
Yeah, now get out of here, idiot.
Looking good, man. Looking good.
Think you're going? Definitely not through here. Get out of my face.
Welcome back, Mr. Kazim. Do you have the picture?
No, I don't.
Okay. Come back when you do. I'll be waiting.
I just want to remind you about the lockdown drill tomorrow. That's right, 900 hours. And the key cards to activate the alarms are still in the safe in the security room. Yeah, same code. 6927. Just don't tell your mother I'll have to shoot.
Okay.
A calendar function. We can use this to summon the partners to a fake meeting, 47. All right, I'm no hacker like Olivia, but I think you need to pull one of the racks here to gain access to the terminal. Damn it. A silent alarm has been tripped. Security is on its way. Hide, 47. Yes, sorry about that, 47. Let's try again, shall we? I think I've got it. We'll need a key card to gain access. Someone in maintenance should have one we can borrow for a spell.
Hey. I thought about what you said.
Yeah, I changed my mind.
It was an insane idea to start with. Exploding golf ball. I don't want blood on my hands.
I've never taken things as much as a dream before.
sir. Yeah, that's more like it. Don't come back.
Hey, how you doing?
Excuse me! Don't move!
Damn.
Must have done something. Can you see anything different in the room? Access the terminal and use the calendar option to summon the Providence partners to a meeting. Good work. The meeting has been booked. The partners should be moving up here shortly. Looks like the lounge can be sealed off for private conversations. Handy. Elevator doors are now open. Building cameras are now disabled. Excellent. I see the partners moving. You should join their meeting. Time to end this, 47. Cameras are showing a lot of guards up here. They wouldn't suspect one of their own, though.
Looking good today, sir.
Partners are alone now. I'll activate the panel controlling the room's security features. When you're ready, use it to start the show. Now we'll just wait for the partners to be alone. Then you can activate the room's lockdown feature.
No, but I've known this man for a long time. He wouldn't call us up here without good reason. I trust his people will have multiple scenarios ready for us very soon. Which reminds me, we need...
I told you to leave, didn't I?
No, but I've known this man for a long time. He wouldn't call us up here without good reason.
Nitro, please vacate the room. This is a private conversation.
What are you still doing in here? Leave us. No, but I've known this man for a long time.
This. Carl, did you do that?
I certainly did not. I have no idea what's going on.
Wait!
Hey! Oh, shit!
Not a patient man, either. Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Providence will soon be no more than a bad memory. 47. Thank you. I'll meet you at the rendezvous on the edge of town.
Just keep calm.